Welcome back, sensation seekers. I'm getting late start of this. It's already 7:34. But I had some stuff to do today, and my buddy Jamie just came down for about 2 hours, so I delayed the process until then. Fair to say, this is Wino Wednesday for 27th of May, 2015-ish. One of those years, anyway. Now, if you recall, last week, I had this. Bear Flag California Smooth Red Wine Blend. And, sexy label and stuff like that. All kinds of regular. It was probably the worst wine that I have tried so far in this series. Plunk. I like this song. Meet Me Down by the River, I'll Be on My Knees, or something like that. I thought it was the same girl that did Lord. I thought it was the same girl, but apparently it's not. She'll have to go to be better looking than Lord, though. Yeah, she dresses up in her pale face, dead body kind of makeup. Anyway, so never anyone known to learn anything for nothing. Here we have Bear Flag Dark Red Wine, California. And let me get... I'll give you a slow twirl of the bottle. Has the UPC code up here. Let's see if it says anything. Red Wine, product of USA. Apparently it's good with... Oh, and screwed up. Of course, everyone knows I had a black fly there. I wasn't pounding my head to pound on my head. Alright. So we went from... Bear Flag, California... Smooth Red Wine Blend... to... Bear Flag Dark Red Wine, California. So let's see if this is any better. Well, it smells like wine, and it smells like a dry red wine. Somewhat better than the other stuff. That doesn't transmit in a good taste, though. What percentage this is? The other one was 12.5. 13.5. Red Wine Blend, California. Well, lo and behold, I'll have to say that this Bear Flag California Smooth Red Wine Blend and Dark Red Wine California is shite. Look up in the dictionary of plunk and you'll find these two red wines. They bear little resemblance to the other stuff that I had so far. They just don't taste good. They're just strong and offensive, and I don't know. They missed on all flags here. Huh. Anyway, have a seat. Oh. So we'll keep this video short. I got a lot of things open up here. Which will take some of the steam off this horrible wine. Oh, look at that. I got some peanut chips. 9045 halogen headlamp. Times one. And this is what I ordered through the internet and eBay to replace the driving or fog lamp in my truck. But at the same time, I ordered HID lamps that are much brighter, and they seem to be working. So this would be a spare for the next time that goes out. Oh, today I got this. This is from Amazon. Oh, pull tab to open. Get away from me, Ben. Let's see what's going on here. Ooh, excellent. I got a couple of books. Actually, I have two of the same. Build a Smokehouse. Now, as you already seen, I've solved my smokehouse smoker thing by getting a new fridge. But I ordered this before I knew what I was going to do. And I ordered two because I'm going to give one to my brother Andy. I also have Boston Valves. And this is plugs for my air mattress that I had one that was broken, so I didn't have it. But then again, I found that I had another air mattress that had a big leak in it. So I took the plug out of that and put it into the thing. So now I have two single air mattresses and one queenish or something like that. Suffice to say, I don't really need these anymore. I got a Spark Force fire starter by Ultimate Survival Gear, just because. See, if I ordered a certain amount of value, I got it shipping for free. So, so do I need another Ferrocerium rod after all I have? And I'm making them anyway. No, but it was kind of like I'd spend $5 to save $4. That's neat. Smokehouse. There you go. Oh! Cheers! God, that is vile. I got from, Hamwick House International, 640 St. Andrew Street, Fergus, Ontario. So, Donna, if you're, if you happen to watch this thing, that's from your hometown. Oh, I gotta sharpen up my knife, too. Oh. Ooh. Would you look at that? Ice cream bars. I suspect there's something different to them. The knife is still sharp, but not sharp enough. So we'll squeeze this open. From Fergus, monthly military assault. Oh, and there we have circa post 1953. Well, that's being vaguely vague, I guess. 8th Canadian Hussars, Prince of Lees, all ranks, cap insignia, blah 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 blah. Scarce, yeah, whatever like that. But here is a nice badge for the 8th Canadian Hussars that I'll probably put on my my blue blazer. Kind of thing. I have the Royal Canadian Dragoons, but 4 years I was with the 8th Canadian Hussars, and it was a good time, really. Except they had the Petawa mentality in that let's leave everything to the last moment or something like that, or let's not plan at all. It seemed that way anyway. I didn't really understand it until I got to Petawa and said, "Oh yeah, you idiots act the same way as the Hussars back in 87 when they took over." Anyway, that's enough of the cuss words. It's a nice thing, nice badge. If you are one of my friends that have more time in the Hussars than anything else, stuff like that, and you wish to have something like that, well, give me a note, and I could separate this from anything else. Multi-military shows, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, oh, let's have another plonk. I'm really trying to, it's not getting any better, by the way. Make my video shorter. Oh, that's gone. Abs gone. Here we have merchandise. Canadian Army badge, 8th Princess Louise's. Oh. There you have two badges for ACH. Yeah, keep motivated. Oh. Ah, jeez, I hope I can crash out this video in less than 15 minutes. La di da da, I'm here, you're there, you're black, I'm white, blah blah blah. And. Ah! Excellent! This is an 8th Canadian Zara badge, but it is all made out of brass, I think. Brass or bronze? So it is totally different than the hat badge I wore. Prince Louise's Hussars. I wonder if I can polish that up to make it shine, or should I bother trying to? What do the officers wear? I mean, the Royal Canadian Dragoons, we wore brass hat badges, but the officers wore blackened ones because nobody could trust them around a bottle of Brasso without them actually drinking the Brasso. So I don't know about this one here. It's very different, and it's very nice. I think I like it. So that's all the mail to be opened, and nothing like that. I think I'll try to force that down. I may not be successful. So the moral of this story is, Bear Flag California Smooth Red Wine Blend, or Dark Red Wine, is atrocious. If you want to impress a date, take her out. Bring her back to your home. Serve boiled wieners on green, moldy slice of bread. Ketchup. And then offer to wash it down with Bear Flag wine. It really is horrible. Everything else I had was drinkable. This stuff is horrible. California. Jesus. I think it was $14 for it too. This just goes to say that you can't judge a wine by its label. This label looks fun and fancy free and stuff like that. But it's absolute crap. Anyway. But you don't have to listen to me. Apparently I'm epically retarded. Or at least my comments can be epically retarded. That's fair. It's a fair deal. Anyway, that's it for now. The beef jerky I made last night turned out pretty good. And I got another batch ready to be sliced off to make any more. Anyway, so thanks for your viewing. Thanks for your support. Thanks for everything else. Hope to see you sometime soon. Either here or there. And from Prince Edward Island, Canada, this is Chris. Out. Special notice to, of course, Frank in Australia.